Don't know about the future, that's anybody's guess. Ain't no good reason for getting all depressed. Buy up your pad and pencil, I give you a piece of my mind. In my opinion, nation, the sun is gonna surely shine. Stop all your fussing, slap on a smile. Come out and walk in the sun for a while. Don't fight the feeling, you know you wanna have a good time. And in my opinion, nation, the sun is gonna surely shine.
Believe how much homework I've got.
Well, you could always pay somebody to do it for you. Or you could change schools.
Change schools. I'd almost forgotten how awful that was.
I won't let you forget it, Blossom. It was a nightmare.
You have no idea how true that is. It really was a nightmare. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
What's wrong, Blossom?
I don't have my homework.
Why not?
My fish ate it.
You're supposed to say your dog ate it.
Ooh, good fix.
This room reeks of fear. I love that smell. Somebody didn't do her homework last night.
Oh my gosh.
It was a simple assignment. Write a medium-length novel which dealt with Chinese foot binding and the miracle of potassium. But no! One of you little twits was just too busy to do this for me. So, tonight everyone writes brand new novels! Now, it wouldn't be fair of me to tell you the name of the girl who caused all this needless suffering. But I will give you a hint. It was Blossom Russo!
That wasn't a hint! Anyone could get that!
If anything should happen to her while I'm gone, there'll be extra credit.
I can explain. See, I don't even want to be in this school. Boy, you guys better get some rest before the debutante ball. You know, you've got this all wrong. She said Blossom Russo? It was just a hint. She meant Blossom Russo, the Korean exchange student. Why don't you guys get a good night's sleep and we'll talk about this tomorrow morning. Or I could scream. Whoa. Why can't I just have sex dreams like everybody else?
Hi, Blossom.
Hi, Anthony. What are you doing?
I was just reading this incredible article. This guy was dancing in a ballet in an outdoor concert in Kansas, right? He does a pirouette, gets caught in a tornado, and actually screws himself into the ground. So, did you tell Dad you want to change schools yet?
No. And I just had this bizarre dream where all of my classmates were zombies from Night of the Living Dead.
That happened to me in real life once. Blossom, you gotta tell him.
I tried to tell him all week. Monday, he had that chat with Mom's divorce lawyer. Tuesday, he got Joey's grades from summer school. And then he lost that job scoring the movie,
Sounds like one of his better weeks.
Public school opens Monday. If I'm gonna go, I gotta talk to him soon. Otherwise, I'm stuck at Crestridge with a bunch of rich girls named Tiffany, whose main goal in life is to get cosmetic surgery and become a trophy wife to some fat guy named Sin.
Just tell him, kiddo. I mean, Dad is a real easy guy to talk to if you can make him see your point.
Yeah.
And if not, I'm sure you and Sid will be very happy together. You can do it. Have a good day. Good night.
Good night, Anthony. Oh, hi, Dad.
Morning.
How was the session?
Oh, thrilling. I spent the night backing up a group that sold 8 million records, and they'd never seen a real piano before. They had a drum machine, two computers, a couple of radios, a synthetic choir, and some guy named Sato with a screwdriver. Sato had the most talent.
Let me help you.
You know,
wonder what kind of people you meet in the supermarket at 5 a.m.? Please, don't say yes.
What happened?
I met this very nice lady who was talking to the fruit. She introduced me to her children. And here they are. Jerry and David. The twins.
How do you do?
Give Jerry a little squeeze. He likes it. Did you eat my pepperonis?
Your pepperonis?
Yeah. See, I put this pizza in the refrigerator before I go to the studio because nothing makes me happier than cold pepperoni pizza in the morning.
So I guess this is a bad time to talk?
Is it about money, driving, or dating?
No.
It's a great time to talk. What's up?
Okay, here's the thing. I want to be a musician, and the trumpet's like my life, the way you are with the piano. And I've heard they have absolutely the best music class in the entire world at Tyler High, and I'd like to take it, so what do you think?
Blossom, I work with the best musicians in town. If you want to study with somebody, I'll set it up. Piano, drum, screwdriver, I got it covered.
Wouldn't it be better to take it in a classroom situation? It wouldn't cost you anything.
Yeah, but they're not going to let you take a class at a school you don't go to, right?
Well...
And you're not going to leave Crestridge. I love that school. It's got great teachers, small classes, plus my most favorite thing, no boys.
I hate that.
I love that.
I know.
Hey.
What?
Father knows best.
That was the 50s, Dad.
Yeah. I love the 50s.
Okay. Did you do the quiz at the end of chapter 12?
Well, I was going to, but that aerobic show from Hawaii came on.
Joey, why do you think Dad's paying me to tutor you? Do you want to flunk history yet again?
Hey, flunked is a strong word, Blossom.
Yeah, but can you spell it? If you weren't such a jock, you'd never get a chance at this makeup test. You want to spend the rest of your life in the 10th grade?
No, but 3 years wouldn't kill me.
You know what happens if you fail this test? Dad's gonna blame Tyler High. I'll never get out of Crestridge. I'll never have a date. And I'll end up as a librarian in Ecuador teaching the Dewey Decimal System to people with plates in their lips.
Hey, relax, will you?
I can't relax. I'm not gonna have any kind of social life till I get into public school. Then I'll join the band and start meeting people.
Whoa, hold it, hold it. The band?
That's a human reject file.
You think it's really geeky?
Geeky? What kind of person has a goal of being in the Orange Bowl halftime show? You get your big shot while everybody in America's peeing. So we're gonna study again tomorrow, right? 4 o'clock?
Yeah. Little hand 4, big hand 12.
Got it. Hey, listen, do you have my duffel bag? I need it for Las Vegas.
Las Vegas?
Yeah, you know, it's in Arizona. I'm going with some friends.
Dad will never let you go.
Oh, sure he will. It's just a matter of asking him at the exact right time. I'm really good at that.
What's that on your arm?
Oh, isn't this cool? This is a surefire way to pass the test. Check this out.
Oh.
See, I've got the Middle Ages, the Crusades. All that stuff's written from wrist to elbow. And then the Civil War through the Depression is written from elbow to armpit.
I can't read it.
Aha, that's because you need a mirror to look at it. See, it's written backwards, so without the mirror, it's just nonsense.
That's incredible. How long did it take you to do that?
All day. The problem is my arm's not long enough to cover everything.
If they catch you cheating, you're dead meat, Joey, forever.
Hey, relax, will you? Did you know that an actor shot Abraham Lincoln?
Really?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. It's here someplace. Ohad Sekli Kutub. John Wilkes Booth.
This is an excellent plan, Joey. Tell you what. You keep practicing the backward writing. It is so clever. Keep doing it over and over, and eventually you'll be able to write it small enough so that it'll all fit on your arm.
Write smaller. That's it. Oh, thanks, Blossom.
No problem. Idiot.
Shaving chick.
Very smooth.
Thank you.
I want to quit Crestridge and go to Tyler High. Did you hear me, Dad? I want to go to public school. Classes start Monday.
Forget it.
But, Dad, all my friends are at Tyler. It's a terrific public school and a music program.
Whoa, wait, Blossom. Both of your brothers are products of this wonderful public school. One's a recovering drug addict and the other's a recovering brain donor. You are staying where you are.
Dad!
Don't mention this to me again.
Dad?
What?
Nothing.
If Mom were here, she'd let me go.
I'm not interested in your mother's opinion on child raising. Mine's better. As a matter of fact, little Richard's is better. When she walked out on us, she gave up her vote.
You can't stop me.
I can and I will. That's the end of it.
That's not the end of it. I'm getting out of Crestridge.
One way or another.
Hi.
Blossom, what are you doing here?
I registered for class last week.
You are unbelievable. This is so fantastic. So how'd you get your dad to change his mind?
Well, he didn't exactly change his mind.
You've got that look. Like Lucy gave Ethel, like Laverne gave Shirley, like Dan Quayle always gives everybody.
He doesn't know I'm here, Six.
So what you're saying is you're sneaking into school?
Yeah. It's like 21 Jump Street, except I wear less makeup than Johnny Depp.
So what did you tell Joey?
Nothing yet. I'm not gonna do it till it's absolutely necessary.
Hi, Blossom.
It's necessary.
Is your hair different or something?
Look, I've got 2 weeks till school starts at Crestridge, and I'm gonna be here, and I don't want Dad to know, okay?
Yeah, sure.
Wait, you're spending your last 2 weeks of vacation going to school?
That's right.
And you call me dumb?
Hope I'm doing the right thing.
Hi.
I'm doing the right thing.
Come fly with me, let's float down to Peru.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Hey, Tony.
Hey.
Ah! So, you're the pepperoni thief.
Thief? Well, I thought you were leaving these here for me. I wrote you a thank you note.
Thanks for the food, Dad.
That's dude. She rhymes with food. Thanks for the food, dude.
From now on, just leave me a couple, okay?
Cool.
Hey, Tony, you... Nah, never mind.
What? What's on your mind?
Okay, you faced a lot of problems. Maybe you could help me with one.
Did you get busted, Dad?
No. I got into a beef with your sister. I kind of lost it. I came down a little hard on her, and I feel terrible about it.
Hey, Dad, that's understandable. I mean, you're working real hard, making ends meet, raising up 4 kids all by yourself.
3.
Oh, yeah, I counted myself twice. The point is, you're doing a hell of a job, and you're entitled to lose your temper once in a while.
Thanks, Tone. I just don't know what to do about her. I'm stumped. I am completely blocked.
I know that feeling. I've been blocked lots of times.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, what did you do to unblock yourself?
Remember Stacy Fratelli?
Thanks, Tone.
I'm there for you, Dad.
This essay and then do an editorial for the school paper. You know, you've accomplished more in 2 weeks at Tyler than I did all last year plus summer school.
It's my only chance.
What exactly is your plan?
I'm getting letters from all my teachers and I'm giving them to my dad at dinner. He takes me to a restaurant once a month, just the two of us.
Oh, that's good. He won't try to kill you in a crowd.
Yeah.
Blossom, look, I have to show you something. This is the best that I can do.
I heard about this. Wow.
How many times have you tried this?
42. And I still can't fit the dark ages. And the Renaissance blurs when I do this.
Then don't do that.
It always comes so easy for you, doesn't it?
It's a wonder he knows how to feed himself.
Oh, I'll feed him.
I gotta get back to work.
I hate to say this, Blossom, but what happens if your dad doesn't buy it?
In that case, I'll have to get myself thrown out of Crestridge.
Come in. Hello, Blossom.
Hello, Mrs. Whiting.
Sit down. I'm thrilled to have you back at Crestridge for another year.
Actually, Mrs. Whiting, that's my problem. You see, I want to go to public school.
Oh, Blossom, I'd hate to see that happen. What does your father say about this?
He says pretty much what you're saying, but with a vein throbbing in his forehead.
Well, I think maybe you'd be wise to listen to us.
Well, to tell you the truth, I'm getting sick and tired of listening.
Blossom!
Oh, I'm sorry. Where's my head? Would you like a cigarette?
There is no smoking here at Crestridge, young lady. Put that out.
Hey, chill, moms. Don't have a cow, okay? There, happy now? Jeez.
What's wrong with you, Blossom?
Nothing a little belt from that bottle in your desk drawer wouldn't cure.
You are just about on your way out of here, young lady.
All right, Granny, I see what you're getting at. How much is it going to take to stuff an old bird like you? Well, obviously, you could use a new dress. Oh, by the way, your can's on fire.
Oh, my God!
Gee, Mrs. Whiting, see how easily accidents can happen? Well, that was nice.
Yeah. It's good for my image to be seen with a beautiful young girl every now and then. So what's been going on with you the last couple of weeks?
What do you mean?
What do I mean? Well, you're in your room all night. When I go into your room, you jump 6 feet, and you haven't done anything even remotely annoying.
Are you saying I'm not normal unless I'm annoying?
Yeah. What's going on?
Well, okay. These letters.
Nick! How are you?
Hey, Mike. Nice to see you.
What are you up to?
Oh, mostly session work. Are you still teaching?
Yeah, I'm over at Tyler High. Wait till you hear the brass ensemble I put together. These kids are incredible.
Oh, really? Well, you ought to hear Blossom play the trumpet sometime. I guess she dropped something.
What do you mean, hear her play? She's in my group. Didn't you tell him, Blossom?
Not yet.
She's my best new student.
Thank you.
Well, see you around, huh, Nick?
Goodbye, Mike.
Bye, Mr. Henderson.
This is not good, Blossom.
I can explain.
How did you register?
I kind of forged your name.
Well, you're kind of in big trouble.
So, what did she do?
She goes to Tyler High, and she gets all these letters from her teacher saying how great she's doing there, how she's starring in the music class, working on the school paper, getting all A's. She even started a chess club, for crying out loud.
Boy, no wonder you're mad.
She did this whole... She did this whole thing behind my back, Tony.
You know, Dad, there was something in Dear Abby today that I think you'll find apropos. She said, hair transplants can be a traumatic experience in any man's life.
What has that got to do with this?
Dad, I can only take you so far.
Dad, I did it! I aced my history exam! Slam dunk!
Hey, congratulations! What did you get?
C minus, 68, and that's out of 100!
Big improvement.
Yes, I am stoked. Hey!
Did you cheat?
Blossom, I got a C minus. Of course I cheated.
How'd you do it?
Oh, it was great. Foolproof. I kept going over the stuff, practicing writing it backwards, like you said,
yeah.
You know? And after a while, I actually started to remember some of this stuff.
So how'd you cheat?
I hit it in my head.
What?
Yeah, it was great. See, nobody could tell I was cheating, because since I didn't write anything down, there was no evidence. Amazing, huh?
Yeah. Absolutely amazing.
Dad? Dad?
Yeah?
Since I did so well on my test, I was wondering if...
Yeah?
Well, some guys, you know, are going out of town for the weekend, and...
Bunch of guys out on the old road, huh?
Yeah, see, they're going up to Vegas, and they want me to go with them.
Vegas, huh? Hot town, Vegas. A 24-hour town, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. Joey, do you see the word stupid written across my forehead anywhere?
No.
So, what was your question again?
Can I go to Vegas? Okay, I'm leaving.
You really helped him with his test.
He helped himself. A complete and total accident, but he did.
I read all those letters you got at school. Very impressive.
Dad, I'm sorry I did it the way I did it, but I really couldn't think of any other way to prove myself or the school to you.
Yeah, well, what you did was pretty amazing, but the way you did it was pretty dishonest.
So I suppose I'm not going to get out of my room till the year 2000 or something, right?
Did you ever think about why I said no?
I assumed it was because you're basically mean and nasty.
That's only part of it. I'm real scared, Blossom.
What are you scared of?
I'm raising you alone, and I don't know how to do that with a girl. I was hoping you'd get to be about 12 and just stay there.
I don't understand. Do you think I'm gonna turn into some psycho teenage mutant nymphomaniac or something?
See, you do understand. At Crestridge, I feel like you're protected from the world a little bit. From boys and dating and drugs and all that stuff that gives me nightmares to think about.
I hate to burst your bubble, Dad, but short of a convent in the Andes, no place is gonna keep me out of trouble. Only I can do that.
What's the name of this convent?
Dad.
I'm kicking and screaming all the way, Blossom, but if Tyler High is what you really want, I'll let you go.
Really?
Really. I believe in you. I trust you. Well, look, since you're gonna be going to school with boys, is there anything you need to know? Any questions you wanna ask?
Nah, you've been through enough today.
Oh, thank God.
Well, it did work out for the best.
Yeah. Plus, Joey learned to hide things in his head.
You know, we gotta remember this, Blossom, so that when our daughters get to be 14 and they want to go to a public school with boys, we'll understand.
Right. And we'll sympathize because we'll know from experience that going to a co-ed school is really no problem for a level-headed girl.
Right. And we'll let our daughters go.
Right.
Nah.
Thank you.